In part C, we want to find the reflection coefficient, but we're not given ZL, so we can't use our usual equation ZL minus Z0 over ZL plus Z0 to find the reflection coefficient. So we'll have to find another way. But we do have here some information about Vmax and Vmin. And there's another way we can write S, using the fact that at Vmax, we have the two voltage phasors, the positive and negative voltage phasors, are aligned with each other. So, for example, we could write V max is V naught plus 1 plus the voltage reflection coefficient magnitude. And then similarly for V min, we can write V naught plus 1 minus, because at this, for a V min, the phases are anti-parallel, so we subtract the two, pointing in opposite directions. And since both of the V naught pluses show up in both the numerator and the denominator, they would cancel. So another way to write S is just what's in the inside here. So we have 1 plus voltage reflection coefficient magnitude over 1 minus the voltage reflection coefficient at the load. So now we can rearrange terms and solve for the voltage reflection coefficient at the load, because we know this is equal to 2.5. So for that we get S minus 1 over S plus 1. We can plug in 2.5 minus 1 over 2.5 plus 1, and we get 0.43.